Now, my What the Farage moment. I did a couple of weeks ago say that I feared our society was being divided into majabbed and majab nots. In this country, about 12% of people have not had the vaccine, and they're very unlikely to get the vaccine. Tens of thousands, in fact, left the care sector last week, and that may well become the National Health Service in the spring of next year. And it seems that the threat level against those who will not have the vaccine is going up, but it's going up more quickly across the continent of Europe than it is here. In Austria, Chancellor Schallenberg, who had threatened a couple of weeks ago that if people didn't have the vaccine, they may well get treated differently. Well, from midnight last night, 2 million Austrians, that, of course, in a relatively small country, only 65% of Austria has been double jabbed. 2 million Austrians from midnight last night have been locked down. Yep. They are allowed to leave their houses for essential purposes, but if they're found to go out for non-essential purposes, or if they even attempt to go to a restaurant or a bar, they are now liable to fines. And I keep having this debate, you know, if those that have had the vaccine can still pass the virus on, why are we being just that tough on those that do not, for whatever grounds, not want to have this vaccine? Do they pose a greater risk of passing on the virus? Well, what one expert last week told me that they do. I'd like to see some real scientific proof of that, because the Prime Minister himself said that even if you've had the double jab, you can still get COVID again and you can still pass it on. It's just that you're less likely to become seriously ill. And that question I'm going to keep asking over the course of the next few weeks. I think what's happened in Austria overnight is deeply sinister. To take a real chunk, you know, to take 35% of your adult population and treat them entirely differently because they haven't done what you've asked them to do in terms of getting a medical treatment, I think it's outrageous. But more than that, I think it's actually very, very dangerous indeed. Now, one of those, I mean, talk about a What the Farage moment, one of those who has brought in the toughest lockdowns across the United Kingdom, one of those who has made it law in Wales to say that face coverings must be worn in all indoor public places, is, of course, the First Minister of Wales, Mark Drakeford. Yep, Drakeford, the tough guy. Drakeford, but it turns out, Drakeford, the do as I say, but not as I do. Let's have a look at the First Minister of Wales out socialising at a Diwali reception. Going for it, dancing. Not much social distancing going on there, First Minister. Not many face masks in evidence either. And the pathetic excuse that we get back from the Welsh Government is that you don't actually have to wear face masks if you're in premises where food and drink is being served. I mean, you just couldn't make this stuff up, could you?